Today's recipe is this amazingly flaky roti. A little bit different than what you're probably used to, but look at this. Soft, flaky, look at that. Wow. It is just perfect. It's amazing.
Go ahead and grab these ingredients and let's get started. I add all of my dry ingredients into a medium mixing bowl. The cake flour in the recipe results in a softer texture, and then I grate cold butter into the recipe as well, which helps to keep it flaky. I add in my warm water in batches. This way I ensure that the texture of the dough is soft enough, but not too wet or not too dry. Once the dough starts to stick to my fingers, I transfer it to a lightly floured work surface and continue kneading it until it's soft and not sticky anymore. Amazing! I transfer it back to the bowl, cover, and rest for 20 to 30 minutes. It becomes nice and pliable. I divide the dough into 6 equal portions. I then roll them out into 10 to 12 inch rounds. I rub all over the round with a combination of ghee and extra virgin olive oil. This is going to help keep the dough nice and flaky. I use a bench scraper to cut halfway through the dough and then roll it up in a coil-like fashion. Tuck the two ends into the center. And there you have it. I continue rolling out the rest of my dough and greasing them generously. It's important to grease it all over with the ghee and fat to help create that layered flakiness. At this stage, I cover the pre-shaped dough loosely. 10 to 15 minutes later, it's very pliable and ready for the next and final step. I roll the pre-shaped dough into a 10 to 12 inch circle. I'm looking to shape the round very thinly. This way it cooks quickly and evenly. I heat and grease my cooking vessel. This is called a tawa. I then add the dough onto the hot tawa. And when I start to see these beautiful bubbles, that tells me it's time to flip. And I grease it generously with the ghee and extra virgin olive oil on both sides. I allow it to get lightly browned, remove it, and then clap, 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 clap. This softens the dough. I continue the process of rolling out my dough into rounds, cooking them on the tawa, greasing them generously. When clapping the roti, sometimes it's too hot for me to handle. I usually put it between kitchen towels and clap it. These rotis will always come out soft because of the use of cake flour and the cold butter. Wow, amazingly soft.
Wow, this is so flaky and soft. Has an amazing flavor. It's perfect. You have to try this version of the roti. It's so delicious.